Hey, what is going on, everybody? How are you all doing today? I hope you all are having a wonderful and fantastic day today, and if not, hopefully you all will have a better tomorrow. So today, I wanted to have a discussion about the possible ways to defeat Salem. Now, looking at Volume 6, Chapter 3, it has told us about Salem's immortality, and it's been led up that she can't be beaten, but that's not entirely true. So sit back, relax, I hope you all enjoy, and let's go ahead and get started. So, we learned a lot in Volume 6, Chapter 3, and there's a lot I still have yet to say about it, which I will go into in the future. But what we did learn is that Salem and Ospen, they realistically cannot die by natural means. But this also doesn't mean that Salem is unbeatable, because there is a couple of ways that actually can lead to Salem's actual defeat. Now, going back on Volume 6, Chapter 3, Salem herself was saved by Ozma when he rescued her from the tower that she was imprisoned in. Now, looking at this, she was originally an ordinary person. She was a human like any other. She was not this monster that she was led up to be believed as. She was an ordinary human. And then, over time, that changed. But looking at it, and looking at the whole situation after the gods wiped humanity, destroyed everything, and Salem was the only one left, and then humanity rose back again, Ozma made the deal with the Light God to actually come back, we do see that Ozma and Salem basically continued their love life. They continued where they left off at last. And it really shows you that Salem is a redeemable character still. And yes, while there may have been their conflicts leading to Ozma's death and their children and all that, this tells you one thing, that despite the problems that actually occurred between the two of them, and since we know the curse now that Salem has, there's a possibility that she herself could actually die, and that is if she learns the values of life. Now, the way that could actually be possible is if Ozma himself decides to, I guess you could say, try to work things out with Salem. Now, that sounds like the Disney ending, of course, but that could be a possibility, and they could work things out, and then Salem could be redeemed in this way, and these two could possibly lead the people to actually trying to unite humanity as one, which they were starting to realistically do before the whole conflict between them rose. And this is something that's likely. It's possible that Ozpin could decide to change his ways of trying to fight Salem and rather try to work things out. But looking at the way that this is going and the way this is set up at this point, considering Salem's anger and her hatred towards Ozpin, it seems that this is going to be hard to be able to achieve even so. But if these two actually put aside their differences, then maybe they could lead the people. Maybe they could lead humanity to peace. That could be a possibility. But seeing Ozpin and how he stands on the situation, I don't think that's likely to happen. I mean, it could, but I don't think it's likely to happen because he just seems like he just wants to stop her at all costs. And the more fighting that keeps happening, the more and more that these two will not reconcile their differences. They will not work it out. And it will just lead to more bloodshed. It'll lead to more individuals dying. And so, this seems like it may not happen in this way, since Ozpin just thinks that he has to stop Salem rather than try to work things out, when it seemed like he really could have actually worked things out with Salem. In the backstory, whenever they tried to talk about things, he just decides to walk out instead, which then only caused this conflict to occur. So, it does seem like Salem is unbeatable. Now, while that seems like that might likely be the case, Salem is not an unbeatable force. Now, I know what you're probably thinking. How is Salem not an unbeatable force if she can't die? And yes, with an immortal, yeah, you would think, oh, well, they can't be stopped. They will continuously come back. Well, that's not entirely the case here, because there is still a method that can be used to actually defeat Salem. Now, while that sounds strange, I think it's a good possibility, and that character is obviously none other than the protagonist, RWBY, because the reason why I state RWBY is the one who has the possibility of actually taking down Salem is actually because of the silver eyes. Now yes, while I know The silver eyes are a big thing when it comes to RWBY's character that still need to be solved. We do actually know some things that the silver eyes are actually capable of. So going back over Crow's statement of the silver eyes back at the end of Volume 3, he states, "Back before Huntsmen, before Kingdoms, it was said that those born with silver eyes were destined to lead the life of a warrior. You see, the creatures of Grimm, the most fierce of monsters mankind had ever encountered, were afraid of those silver-eyed warriors. They were the best of the best. It was said that even a single look from one of these fighters could strike a Grimm down." And where this statement is actually important, the silver eyes can also take down the magic of the maidens, which goes back to the old ancient magic of the ancient times before humanity fell. Because remember, this magic is also Ozpin's magic that he gave to the maidens that was passed down. And Salem even states that Cinder is weakened by the power of the silver eyes because of the fall maiden powers. So it shows that not only are the Silver Eyes good against the Grimm, but the Silver Eyes are also good against the powers of the old magic ways, it seems. So it seems that the weakness to the magic is the Silver Eyes as well. And this leads into another thing. If you remember what RWBY did to the Grimm Dragon, it's frozen. It's not dead, but it is frozen after what happened at the Fall of Beacon when Cinder killed Pyrrha. And then RWBY's silver eyes triggered, activated, even gave Cinder the inflictions of damage that she had on her body afterward, why her arm was gone and she had to have a replacement, as well as why her eye was damaged. And then the reason why I'm also saying that RWBY is the one to stop Salem is also because Ozpin throws the question at Jin, "How do I defeat Salem?" And she says, "You can't." Doesn't mean that there's not a possibility, it just means that Ozpin himself directly cannot do it. Therefore, he would probably have to have the assistance of another individual. And that individual, in my opinion, would lead to RWBY. And another thing that you have to remember, Hazel and Watts had also been taking care of silver-eyed warriors, if you remember the statement back in Volume 4. This makes me think that Salem is probably trying to target Silver-Eyed Warriors so that she can't have anyone oppose her abilities and her powers. And while that be the case, that's an interesting thought. That means that Salem may potentially fear these Silver-Eyed Warriors because of this very case, because they hold a power that could actually stop her. Not kill her, but stop her, because she could be frozen in the end, just like the Grimm Dragon. That is a possibility that comes to mind here, and that is something that Salem may not want to have happen to herself, considering that she has a goal to accomplish as well. So, in the long run, RWBY is actually in endangerment, and while Salem did send Tyrion to capture RWBY, this could be because, at the same time, this could counter Ozpin's magic as well. Although, over time his magic has dwindled, it is not gone as of yet. He just said that it's gotten weaker. So this could still be a way for Salem to possibly even try to use RWBY herself to take down Ozpin. So you see, it seems more like the case could be whoever wields the Silver-Eyed Warrior wields the fate to stopping the other individual. But anyways, let me know what you think down below. Do you agree? Do you disagree? Let me know down below. And I just wanted to say, the North American Thanksgiving was yesterday, and I just want to say, if there's one thing I'm thankful for, I'm certainly thankful for each of you. Your support and just talking to all of you, you all are wonderful, and I just wanted to thank each and every single last one of you. You all are fantastic, and I appreciate all of you, and I can't thank all of you enough for your support, so thank you all. But I want to know what you all are thankful for. Let me know down below, and thank you all for watching. I hope you all enjoyed, and if you did enjoy, hit the video with a like, subscribe if you want to see more content like this, and share this with your friends if you found this informative or useful. Well, anyways, I hope you all have yourselves a wonderful and fantastic day today, and remember, if today was not a good day, tomorrow could always be better. Take care of yourselves and everyone around you, and have yourselves a good one out there, everybody.